Hey, what's poppin', YouTube family? Wait, wait, wait. Cut to the beat.
I know you like that.
How long you been back, man?
Welcome. I see the girls in the club, they getting wild for me. And all the pretty chicks all wanna smile at me. These rap cats, man, they all got this style for me. And if I ever see them, man, they probably bow to me. And when this beat drop, I know they gon' lean. World debut.
Hey, what's up? If you're new here and this is your first time seeing my face, my name is Mark. Please remember to slash that like button, and also please remember to annihilate that subscribe button and hit that post notification bell. Also, leave me comments down below. But I think I've talked enough, so let's just jump straight into these reactions. Let's go! Okay, so let's get this started. We're about to get into Gims again. I'm very excited to react to this. Gonna be reacting to Gims. Le Prayer Payeur. I think that's how you say it. Le Prayer Payeur, which I think means in French, the price to pay, if I'm not mistaken. Somebody let me know in the comments below. I think that's what it means though. But we're about to jump into this. Okay. Is this a this is an actual song. I thought this was a commercial at first. Come on, Gims. I'm very anxious to see how this is about to go down. Like, I'm not sure if this is going to be fast or if this is going to be slow. Okay. Got a knife. Ooh, okay. Whoa, I felt that. Okay, so already off rip, what I'm getting from this, at least from Gim's aspect, is that it's almost that you're basically willing to sign over your soul, so to speak, to gain affirmation, to gain acclaim, to gain power and prestige. That's at least from the imagery of what I'm getting, at least how he just slit his wrist and signed the contract with blood. It's almost like this, like a new Illuminati-esque type of vibe that I'm getting from this track already. But let's jump back into it, because there wasn't even anything said and already the creativity is on point. Because I was not expecting that. She giving me like Matrix vibes over there. Come on, Gims. On fait des choses qu'on regrette vraiment. Avec le temps, j'ai pris des serments. J'ai fait sincèrement. On oublie bêtement. Je rêve d'une vie où je m'endors sagement. Je suis conscient que je te dois tellement. Avec le temps, j'ai prêté serment. Je l'ai fait sincèrement et je le dis clairement. J'ai fait des choses que je regrette vraiment. On me dit, mais si tu tiens, combien ce. Yeah, this is definitely giving me like a Matrix movie type of vibes with Keanu Reeves, especially how she came to the door and the way she just looked like out of there. Like, she just looked like. Yeah, that was definitely Matrix. I wonder, was Gims inspired by the Matrix when he made this? This is dope. I like this.
J'ai continué ma route, j'ai continué.
And I want to say that I love how Gims is like so technical with his enunciation and his flow and the way he sings and raps. Like, I think it's so dope because it's as if he uses his voice as another instrument with on a track, and it marries so well with the melody and the beat and the lyrics that he's saying. Like, it meshes so well. It's like a gumbo. Like, when you throw everything together and you get like this beautiful blend of like food.
On fait des choses qu'on regrette, c'est vrai. Et j'ai appris à mettre en retrait. Parfois je suis distrait et j'en ai trop fait. Je vis la nuit car je rêve en secret. Tous ces mots que je vais emporter dans les épreuves, je me suis enfermé. Je me mets en danger, je construis, je défais. On fait des choses qu'on regrette, c'est vrai.
That looked like an Illuminati sign right there. Hold on, it was a triangle. Almost. Or it's kind of like branded from like how they did it like in the Matrix. I like that.
On me dit, mais y du tien, combien se perd en chemin? Que ferais-je si j'étais toi? Que ferais-tu si t'étais moi? On me dit, mais y du tien, combien m'ont tendu la main? Si j'étais toi, que ferais-tu si t'étais moi? Je sens comme déjà vu, j'ai perdu mon temps. Et j'ai rien pu faire à part serrer les dents. J'ai rêvé ma vie à travers la vitre. On désire sans effort la miséricorde. Celui qui prend la vie est derrière la porte. Là tu réalises que tout est passé si vite. J'ai continué ma route.
So that's, like I said, that's basically what it seemed like that I was getting at from the story. It's like he's basically had to sign, like, it's almost as if he's portraying this person who had to sign over his soul to basically the devil to gain the acclaim that he has and the prestige that he has and the accolades that he has. Not saying that that's what he actually physically done, but it seems like that's the point that he's trying to drive home of that, how artists do. Because like I said, English, since English is my first language, I'm just going by the aesthetic and the visual of what I see. And it seems like he's telling this story about how artists tend to sell their souls to corporations and the machine just to become famous and popular and to gain popularity. It's not about talent almost. It's almost as if you have to sit there and become like this sacrificial lamb just to be able to gain those accolades and the prestige and to utilize and push yourself forward. Let's jump back into this. I love that melody right there, that breakdown. Yeah, and that's what happens. This is what happens in real life. They sit there and try to utilize to prey on your downfall. Yeah, it's like an occult type thing.
On désire sans effort la miséricorde. Celui qui prend la vie est derrière la porte. Là tu réalises que tout est passé si vite.
Are they about to try to sacrifice? Oh, they were trying to sacrifice him. Whoa.
J'ai continué ma route. Continué ma route. J'ai continué ma route. J'ai continué ma route. Continué ma route.
I love that. That was dope. That was dope. I love Gim's storytelling capability.